Hello and welcome back to the channel. So from today, we are going to start our journey in the one of the most popular technology in big data, which is Hadoop. So let's get started. But before going to Hadoop, you should know some basic concept of big data. So if you're not familiar with big data, I have made a playlist which is dedicated to big data basic concept, which you can find it in the description below. But let me give you an overview of what is big data. So big data refers to a data set which is too large to be manageable by the traditional computers to store and processing. So the major problems faced by big data falls under three V's, which are known as volume, velocity and variety. This we have already discussed in detail in our previous lectures. So if you want to know more, just hit pause and first watch that playlist so you'll get a clear idea of what is big data. So now you'll ask, what is the difference between big data and Hadoop? So big data is nothing but a term, it's a concept, and Hadoop is a technology which is implemented to handle the big data problems. Now we will discuss why this Hadoop is needed. So there are many issues which every company faced in the earlier era. So those are nothing but storage of large data sets, as well as handling different file formats and the data which is generated with high speed. So as you already know, the feeds from Facebook, Twitter are generating petabytes of data every day. So to handle it, we need some solution, and the answer is big data. So now you'll ask, what really is a Hadoop? So Hadoop is the solution of the big data problems that we have just discussed. So it is nothing but a technology for storing and processing large amount of data on cheap commodity hardware in a distributed manner. And not only, it also provides the data analytics through distributed computing. So it is developed as a project by Apache Software Foundation. And the main inventor of Hadoop is duck cutting. But you will ask, what is the meaning of the word Hadoop? Duck cutting's kid named Hadoop to one of its toy, which was nothing but a yellow elephant. So Duck then used that name for his open source project because it was easy to spell, pronounce and not use anywhere else. It's interesting, isn't it? So that's why the logo is also an yellow elephant. So let's have some introductory part of Hadoop. So as we already discussed, it's Apache's open source platform which is written in Java and allows distributed processing and storing of large data set across a cheap commodity hardware, which can be easily replaceable, and it was originated by Duck Cutting and Mike Caffarel. So it is designed to scale up in a horizontally manner from single machine to thousands of machines, which serves as a computation and storage layer. So now let's discuss about Hadoop architecture. So Hadoop contains three core components, which are nothing but HDFS, which is Hadoop Distributed File System, which is a storage layer for Hadoop, the MapReduce, which is a processing layer, and YARN, which is a resource management layer. So we will discuss each of these components in detail. The main component of Hadoop is a Hadoop Distributed File System, which is HDFS. So it's a storage layer for Hadoop, and it has a master-slave architecture. So master is nothing but a high-end machine, whereas the slaves are a commodity hardware. In HDFS, data files are divided into multiple blocks. Preferably, each block has a size of 128 MB or 256 MB by default. So for example, let's consider we have a 1 GB of file, and if the block size is 128 MB, so it will divide those into 7 to 8 blocks. And it will store it in a distributed fashion on clusters of slave nodes. And on the master, the metadata resides. So it will have the address and all of the information of the blocks which are stored in the slave nodes. So basically HDFS has two daemons running for it, which are name node and data node. Basically name nodes run on the master machine, which is a high-end hardware. And it is responsible for maintaining, monitoring and managing the data nodes. So it acts as a master in HDFS. So it records the metadata of files like the location of blocks, the file size and the permission allotted to that file, as well as the hierarchy. It also captures the changes in metadata like deletion, creation, renaming of the file in the edit logs, and it regularly receives heartbeats and block reports from the data node, which means it closely works with the data node to store all the information of our data files. The second component is a data node. Data node runs on the slave machine, which are nothing but commodity hardware which are easily replaceable and cheap to buy. So it stores the actual big data files. As we see, our 1GB file has 7 to 8 blocks. So these 7 to 8 blocks will be stored in the data node in distributed manner. Data node does all the groundworks from creating, replicating, as well as deleting the blocks on the command of name node. This is the architecture of HDFS, from which you can understand more clearly how the process is working. So this is the name node, which has all the metadata such as name, path and replicas, as well as block size. And these are the data nodes, which contains the actual files. Hadoop's next core component is MapReduce. So MapReduce is a data processing layer of Hadoop, and it has two phases. The first one is a map phase, and the second one is a reduce phase. So what really are those? So map phase applies business logic to the data. The input data will be converted into a key value pair. So as you can see in this example, we have provided input as a business data. It is splitted, and the map phase converted into a key value pair. And the second phase is a reduce phase. So reduce phase takes input from the map phase, and it applies the regression based on the key of the key value pairs. So as you can see, it is combining and applying aggregation based upon the transformation which we are applying to our data file. And after that, we are getting the output to the console, or it is written in the HDFS. So let me tell you step by step how the MapReduce process is working. So first, client specifies the file for input into the map function, and it splits it into tuples. After that, map function will define the keys and values from the input file, and the output of the map function will be nothing but key value pairs. After that, the MapReduce framework will sort the key value pairs from the map function, and it merges the tuples having the same keys together. After that, the reducers get the merged key value pairs as an input, and then it will apply the aggregation functions on these key value pairs. And lastly, the output from reducers will be written to HDFS as per our requirement. So this is how the MapReduce works. And the third core component of Hadoop is YARN. YARN is a short form for yet another resource negotiator. And it has the following components, such as resource manager and node manager. This is the architecture of YARN running on Hadoop. So the first component is a resource manager. Resource manager will run on the master node, and it knows where is the location of all the slave nodes. Also, it is aware of how much resources each slave have. There is a service known as resource scheduler, which runs by the resource manager. So this service will decide how the resources will get assigned to various tasks. After that, application manager is there, which will negotiate the first container of the application. Also, the resource manager will keep track of all the bits coming from node manager. The next component is a node manager. So node manager will run on the slave nodes. It manages the containers. You will ask, what are really these containers? Containers are nothing but a fraction of node manager's resource capacity. So basically, node manager will monitor the resource utilization of each container, and it sends their bits to the resource manager. So this is how YARN will work as a resource management layer of Hadoop. So in this lecture, we have seen what is big data, the difference between Hadoop and big data, why Hadoop is needed, the introductory part of the Hadoop, and also we have seen the core components of Hadoop and how they work. In the next lecture, we are going to learn the Hadoop ecosystem and all their components in details. So if you like this lecture, please subscribe to our channel and also ring the notification bell to get the latest updates. Thanks for watching.